Creating opportunities by working hand in hand, we can accomplish all our dreams for a better quality of life. Is now within our reach.
Let us take a stand for our vicious alone, making future plans for the people to grow.
A very good morning to all of you. Sawadika to our school leaders, educators, teachers, students from all SEAMEO member countries and around the world. I would like to welcome you all to the second session of the pre-Congress lecture series live here from SEAMEO Secretariat in Bangkok, Thailand. This special lecture series have two sessions. Session one had just finished successfully on 5th of April with the theme Transformation and Innovation in the Post-COVID-19 Pandemic for Schools and Communities. We believe that by watching the success stories, you have learned new ideas on how to improve the environment ecosystem in schools and communities. New pedagogical approaches to nurture, develop, motivate learners in the classroom. We also presented new solutions of teaching techniques, including those for special education. Today is the second or last session of pre-Congress lecture series with the theme Transformation and Innovation in the Post-COVID-19 Pandemic for Teachers and Students. Most of them are members of C-Teacher and C-TVET Network. We believe that 1 hour from now on, you will be inspired to learn good practices shared by teachers and students from among our network in various topics such as new style of teaching and learning approaches, innovation in teaching foreign languages, innovation in teaching science and STEM education, and how to inspire yourself during the pandemic. As this special lecture is a pre-Congress event, it will help prepare you with the SEAMEO Congress 2021 virtual with the theme Transforming Southeast Asian Education, Science, and Culture in the Digital Age. And it will truly serve as valuable resources for discussion during the SEAMEO Congress, which will be streaming live through online platform on 28 and 29th of April. We would like to express our appreciation to all educational institutions and members of SEAMEO family and communities, teachers and students from Indonesia, Philippines, Malaysia, Thailand, and Vietnam, who made great effort to produce the video clips telling their stories of success, which they have applied in their own educational institutions, communities, or even themselves as a self-improvement program during the lockdown period. All 157 entries submitted to us are very good and very impressive. We also learn and so proud of these stories shared with us. These created a lot of pressure to our committee to select the best in terms of production and impact to be presented in a limited time of 1.5 hours. Our criteria for selecting the video is not just the quality and creativity in production, but the stories must be interesting and should include innovation. Practical skills should be embedded and easy to understand. And the last important one is that stories may be replicated and may be useful for teachers and learners. The committee had to review over and over again to ensure that all those who are attending will learn a lot from SEAMEO pre-Congress lecture series. All the video clips that are presented last Monday and in today's session, including all shortlisted and interesting video clips, will be posted on SEAMEO website later on. Therefore, you can learn and apply these innovations and best practices for your schools, communities, teachers, students, and even for yourself. Since the pandemic is still raging in many of our countries, we hope that our lecture series will be beneficial to everyone to keep teaching and learning together. We expect that the stories of success in the video clips could be good models for educational institutions, teachers, and students to learn and replicate for improvement. Now, without much ado, I would like to turn over the floor to our MCs of the day, Ms. Piapa, the Manager of Knowledge Management Office of SEAMEO Secretariat, and Mr. John Paul Itao, the Communication Officer from SEAMEO Spafa, Bangkok, Thailand. So please join us, learn, and enjoy. Thank you very much. Kapun ka.
Thank you very much, and Dr. Ethel, for the inspiring welcome message to our participants. And good morning to all participants again for this morning. And may I introduce myself, Piapa, again from the SEAMEO Secretariat. And today I also have John with me as the guest MC from SEAMEO Spafa. John, would you like to introduce yourself?
Thank you, Kun Piapa. Good morning, everyone. Thank you again for joining us in our second SEAMEO pre-Congress lecture series. It's nice to be here with Kun Piapa again today. And my name is John. I am from SEAMEO Spafa, which is the SEAMEO Regional Center for Archaeology and Fine Arts here in Bangkok, Thailand.
Yes. And in the last session, right, we request the participant to send a reflection to our webinar email address. And because of the chat box on the YouTube has to be closed because of the some technical problems.
Right.
And what happened to that, John?
Right. So in our last session, unfortunately, we had some technical issues with the chat box on YouTube. So we asked our viewers to send their comments, how they felt about the videos. Through the webinar email.
Yes, that's right.
Yeah, and we received a lot of reflections and we've compiled them into this video.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It's interesting to see,
Yeah, let's take a look at the video.
Thank you.
And we would like to thank all the reflections that sending to us, right, John? And if I would like to share more, like, you know, voices and reflection and inputs for this session, how could I do it?
Well, Kumpiapa, unfortunately, the chat box on the YouTube is still closed. So if you would like to send in your reflections for today's session, we have three different channels for you to do so. And you can send in your reflections, your comments about how you feel about the videos today, what you've learned.
Yes.
Yeah. And they can take a picture.
Yes, they can, right? Do the selfie by mobile phone, right?
Right. Just like in the video.
Yes.
Yeah. And you can do it, and you can send it by email, which is the first channel, at webinar@seameo.org, or you can use Facebook.
Yes.
With the hashtag SEAMEO pre-Congress, no spaces and no hyphen in between pre and Congress, or you can use the link to a Google form where you can submit your reflection.
Yes, that's right. And now we have about nearly 60 reflections that, you know, submitted by the participant in the Google link that provide in the description box already.
Right.
Thank you very much for sharing us the good reflections, and that encourage us to produce more quality webinar. Again.
Yes, and we really like to receive these, to hear your feedback and your comments. And it's nice to see, like in the first session,
yes,
that they were able to, that they liked the videos and they were able to apply it.
Yes, that's right. And then if you have additional reflection, you can go back to the link in the YouTube chat description box, and you can send a message to us.
Yes. So Kumpiapa, what are the highlight stories for today's session?
Yes, and for today's session, this is the last session that will highlight the transformation and innovation for teachers and students. And we received many impressive video regarding to this subject. And there are 5 chapters, which are the keynote presentation, and new teaching and learning approach, innovation in teaching foreign language, innovation in teaching science and STEM, and self-inspiration.
Wow, sounds like interesting topics.
Yes, and all of the video produced by the teachers and some by the students.
Students,
yes,
right.
And for the first chapter, John, and we received 2 video clips, and from Dieu Thanh University from Vietnam, and another one from the school division, Damalinas from the Philippines. And this, the content of this video is very important because they're empowering teachers and students to cope with the new technology during the pandemic. So let's learn from them.
Let's learn from these videos.
The COVID-19 pandemic last year has created a huge problem to the operation of our university, in which classes has been disrupted, students had to stay at home, and then we find a very bleak prospect of how we can graduate our students in time. So amidst all of that chaos, our university leadership has made the determination to change. We have acquired a lot of new technology for online learning, and we, over the period of only 3 months, we have invested like more than $500,000 to upgrade our system, our e-learning system and other related systems to support it. It is not just the problem of technology investment for new equipment, but it's also the problem of how to motivate students and instructors at the same time to go to class online. And in fact, to carry out online learning, it takes more time for preparation on the part of our instructors, as well as more self-studying on the part of our students. And to do that, for the student populations of like 25,000 students, that's not easy. But it was lucky that our leadership has been able to motivate the staff of over 1,200 instructors to come in time for this and to share their efforts, their values, and their time. And that had brought about a lot of good results to us in that we have been able to carry out our classes in the normal way. And the fact is that our students can complete their courses on time, and also the graduating batch has made it even like one day earlier than last year, so that our efforts have paid its value. So really, I believe that is a story of success to our university, that even in time of hardship, amidst the great pandemic, we can still overcome it with the determination from our students and our instructors, and also the leadership that has pointed out online learning and online collaboration as a new mode of study in the new era.
Under the effect of the COVID-19 pandemic, many universities across the country, including Yutong University, decided to let the students stay home. To ensure the quality of the teaching and learning process, Yutong University Board of Directors has deployed an online operation model from March 16, 2020. In just over a month, under the direction of the university's board of directors and the effort of all the lecturers, DTU has successfully adopted the on-site and online hybrid education model in response to COVID-19 pandemic. More than 5,000 of the classes have been transformed from offline to online teaching. To ensure the teaching quality during the pandemic, DTU implemented a method of education whereby all the teachers teach in the classroom just like the way they taught before the pandemic. The only difference is that the students do not have to go to class, they follow the lectures online from home instead.
Nhà trường đã rất là chủ động để xây dựng cái học liệu cho các bạn sinh viên theo cái tiêu chuẩn của những cái kinh nghiệm mà trường đã làm các cái kiểm định hữu tế.
Thanks to this approach, students not only felt elated because they were not confused by the new teaching method, but they could also interact directly with the lecturers and keep up with their friends. The quality of teaching and learning is guaranteed as the same as the on-site method.
I found it sensible to conduct study via e-platform as it provided students practical benefits. Distance learning enabled me and other students to be flexible on our time or in arranging our time. And also, it enabled us to absorb knowledge and to have sharp attention to our lecturer's lesson.
Effective delivery of online classes ensured that our learning progress will not be affected by the COVID-19 pandemic.
Despite e-platform teaching, the methods of combining both on-site and online assist students in absorbing knowledge and ensure that students' attitudes towards learning are alike, whether it may be before or after the COVID-19 pandemic.
Sau cái mỗi những buổi học đó, thì mình luôn hỏi những cái phản hồi về cái việc học online này của sinh viên đối với từng lớp khác nhau. Thì đa phần hầu như là các bạn đều có phản hồi tốt về cái việc học online này. Thì các bạn đa phần đều trả lời là học rất là ok, học tập trung.
Phương pháp dạy bằng e-learning trực tuyến như thế này á, sẽ đảm bảo được sức khỏe cho giảng viên và sinh viên.
With this form of live on-site combined online, the proportion of students attending classes has not changed compared to before the pandemic. This was a very good sign showing that the new teaching application of DTU has really worked for the students.
students' higher engagement and increased motivation towards learning is the direct result of the efforts of DTU Board of Directors. At the same time, DTU is the very first university to guarantee that students are able to graduate on schedule despite the COVID-19 pandemic.
Ang City Schools Division of Las Marinas ay buong suporta na kaisa sa natatanging pagtawid ng education system, isang hamon na hindi natin uurungan para sa kabataan.
At the onset of the new normal in education brought about by the pandemic, inevitable changes have happened. One of the major shifts in education delivery is the use of technology. But how do you embrace this change? If you are vulnerable to the dangers of COVID-19 and the new technologies emerging is an unfamiliar territory to your generation.
Ako po si Gina Aileen Welco. Magta 31 years na po akong nagtuturo. Retiree na ako po. Hindi namin panahon yung mga computer niya.
Ma'am Aileen thought that she will be retiring as an agriculture teacher as she is passionate about taking care of animals and plants. Her passion and her prowess in teaching were put to a test when she was tasked to be an EPP course online creator in the Moodle learning platform in the City Schools Division of Las Marinas.
Sabi din sa akin ni Ma'am Sherry, yung aming principal, Ma'am, kaya mo yan at saka matututo ka dyan. Parang na-challenge po ako doon. Kaya sabi ko, okay po. Dalawang module yung ginawa namin. Isang pang-model at saka isang pang-offline. Lahat ng bagay, kung gusto, may paraan. So kung halimbawa iisipin mo lagi mahirap, iisipin mo lagi negative, wala kang tatapos, wala kang mayayari na trabaho. I love your work.
Life goes on, love your work, is Ma'am Aileen's philosophy. That's why she wholeheartedly welcomed the paradigm shift in the field of education. While she admitted that she was not well-versed in using computers, her willingness to learn it with her fellow teachers prevailed.
Ngayon pong panahon ng pandemya, hindi po nakakayanin ng guro lang ang pagtuturo ang pagbibigay ng serbisyo sa aming si COP, meron po kami community of graduate. Kineshare po kasi ng mga teacher yung kanilang mga challenges encountered sa pagtuturo nila. Tapos po yun, meron po kami po mga intervention na ginagawa noong face-to-face pa. May gagawin kami kapraso, hahanap pa ako ng teacher ko, teacher pa na ba tapos, oh, pakitulong, paki-upload mo nga ito, paki-save, paano ko ba isa-save? O yun, pero ngayon po, medyo, hindi naman po ganun kagaling, pero nakakasabay.
You will be amazed that in a short period of time, it is remarkable that a teacher whom we often see in the schoolyard is now a leading figure in embedding lessons in an online learning platform. The teacher who used to get her hands dirty from planting and caring for animals is now keeping up with the demands of modernization. Age never hindered Ma'am Aileen to persevere together with her peers.
Malaki po ang tulong natin sila kasi po tayo naman ay ngayon pa lang dito sa ganito na sitwasyon. Katulad po nga, hindi naman ako masyado kasi medyo may edad na ako. So dito ko lang natutunan sa mga islak na ito, paano ko ibibigit yung mga bata, kung ano yung mga technique na dapat mong ibigay bilang master teacher. Meron kaming Google Classroom. Sinasubmit ng mga teacher yung kanilang mga weekly home learning plan, yung kanilang mga activity sheets, at saka yung mga answer sheets na pinapasagutan sa mga bata. Sine-check namin kung ano yung mga mali, kung ano yung mga hindi masyadong maiintindihan ng bata. So, ipinapaliwanag po namin sa mga teacher. Tapos sa Moodle naman, hindi naman po ganun kadali. Meron ko pang gagawin bago pa diretsyo ma-i-upload sa Moodle. So, unti-unti po yung natutunan. Napakalaking tulong po sa amin ng lab.
Ma'am Aileen represents the 4,438 teaching and non-teaching personnels of the City Schools Division of Las Marinas who are diligent, competent, and persistent as they embrace the new normal in the education sector. While there were doubts early on, she persevered to accomplish tasks with her expertise. Not because she is required to do so, but because of genuine love. Love for neighbors, love for her family that gives her strength, and love for her students whom she considers as her own.
Ako po, si Tingal Pinay-Lizaga. Ang pinakagustuhan ko po sa pagtuturo ninyo, ang tuwing po nag-online class po kami, or nag-online, kasi po dito po nagkakaroon po kami ng talakayan na nai-explain niya po sa amin ang dapat po namin matutunan.
Malaki ang naitutulong ng last session sa mga kaguruan at mga mag-aaral. Nagbibigay ito ng pagkakataon na mapaunlad ang kanilang kakayahan sa pagtuturo na nagbubunga ng positibong pag-unlad at pagkatuto ng mga mag-aaral.
Wow, John, how do you feel about the videos that present for the keto presentation?
Well, I guess in the last video, it teaches us that no matter what your age is, even if you're a teacher, right, you never stop learning.
That's right. And for the reflection from the participant, we receive about over 100 right now.
Wow, we just started and we've received over 100 already.
Yes, from all around, like, you know, Philippines, Malaysia, Brunei, Indonesia, and the other countries as well, like, you know, Thailand and Vietnam. And we would like to encourage more. If you are from other countries beyond Southeast Asia, like Australia, Japan, and you are watching us, please submit the reflection to us so that we can improve the SEAMEO lecture series in
right.
the future.
Yeah, we'd love to hear any feedback, or just tell us how you found these videos inspirational or useful for yourself.
Yes, and John, would you like to give the highlight for some of the reflection?
Sure, so we have this reflection from Maria Catherine in the Philippines, and she says, I am amazed with the innovation put in place with schools and universities around Asia and even in my country, the Philippines.
Yes, and we also received one reflection from Thailand mentioning that the session inspired to motivate both teachers and learners in the COVID pandemic situation.
That's great. Yes, because this session is not only for teachers, but also for students.
Yes, that's right. And how about the next chapter, John?
So in our next chapter, Kun Piapa, we have three videos under the chapter titled New Teaching and Learning Approaches. And although we have three videos under this chapter, they look at three different educational levels.
Yes.
So we have one video, the first one from SK Desa Cempaka in Negeri Sembilan, Malaysia, which is a primary school. And then the next video is from Don Mariano Marcus Memorial State University in La Union, the Philippines.
Yes.
And the last video is from Mater Dei College in Bohol, the Philippines.
Right. I hope that the teacher can apply that technique.
Right. So let's enjoy these videos on new teaching and learning approaches.
And don't forget to come back to send your reflection after you watching this video script.
Hi, we're the
SKDC Superheroes!
As a group, we discussed and felt that when schools reopened after the movement control order, we had to follow new SOPs, let students far apart from our friends and classmates, remaining in our seats throughout learning and during recess, as well as not carrying out extracurricular activities or sports outside the classroom. We were worried that pupils might feel bored, frustrated, or even lose focus because they are sitting for too long during school hours.
Once we knew what the problem was, we straight away thought of ways to overcome it. We imagined pupils being able to take in mental breaks, doing fun activities, moving around, all while abiding to the SOP. Our brainstorming sessions led to brain breaks. Basically, there are short mental breaks, which can either be active or relaxing, that pupils can take in between learning tasks. We thought of suitable activities and materials, and we put them in a box. Voila! The brain breaks box was made.
After we made our first brain breaks box, we presented it to our headmistress and showed it to our teachers and explained how they could use it. Then we went to 10 different classes in our school to carry out the activities with the pupils. Having brain breaks can help improve health, boost attention, and build creative thinking skills. We could certainly see this when we conducted the activities. Not only were the pupils energized during the activities, they were more than ready to learn afterwards.
Because we wanted to make a brain breaks box for every class in our school, we needed funds. So, we invited a company called KA Petra to our school to get to know more about our project. They like it so much, they decided to fund it. Apart from that, we also had a crowdfunding campaign with the help of Impact Hub Kuala Lumpur. In only one day, generous donors have donated more than what we asked for.
We didn't want to keep the brain breaks box to ourselves. We also wanted to impact others. Due to school closures, we couldn't do this physically, so we decided to go online. We recorded a sharing session and streamed it on YouTube. Later, we shared the link to our stream on Facebook, Instagram, and in every WhatsApp and Telegram group we were in. Our link spread like wildfire, and guess what? Even the director of the State Education Department shared the link in his official Telegram feed. Isn't that amazing? We hope to continue to go above and beyond to ensure that all school pupils got the brain breaks they deserve.
Be the change you want to see in the world.
From an ordinary mobile phone, I was able to teach my students and have shared my lessons with the world. A day of peace for all. I am Daniel Ong, also known as Teacher Danny, and I am an elementary teacher and a college instructor at the College of Education of Don Mariano Marcos Memorial State University in the Philippines. Yes, I am teaching using my mobile phone.
The COVID-19 pandemic has affected educational systems worldwide. This has been taken off guard by the education sector and other related institutions. Many stakeholders continue to adapt to the sudden transitions to online study, and this is due to the unavailability of training to take classes online for the majority of the teachers and students. Other schools really have no budget for the changing of face-to-face classes to online learning. That is why a lot of schools here have closed. Even though it is difficult and challenging to continue this academic year in this pandemic, distance education solution has come to the world scene as a glorious savior. Internet is very important in distance education, since it is possible to find and access most transactions via the internet. The way we do things has been changed quickly by ICT. However, lack of internet access continues to impact students' online learning experiences. In some of my synchronous meetings, there will always some time lag problems on video calls due to signal processing and internet congestion issues. During video calls, my screen image follows my actual movements very slowly. If I move my head or speak, there's sometimes a delay of 2 seconds or more before it happens on my screen. But my sympathy goes to those less fortunate learners who are now struggling with a new mode of learning. It is really a big challenge for everyone, not only for the learners, but also for the teachers. The saddest experience here is most of my students cannot attend my classes because of signal delays and sometimes lack of data and internet access, since a lot of them reside in rural upland areas. So as a solution, I started to create videos using my mobile phone and upload them on the internet. Personally, I do not have much wealth to offer, but with these limited resources I have in teaching, I do not limit myself, as there are many ways to teach and learn. And being a teacher, we should always be able to maximize those. We know that students learn best when they take in information via multiple modalities, through reading, drawing, listening to the teacher's explanations, experimenting, and viewing visual media. But how can they see all this if we are physically separated from one another? It was frustrating in the beginning, but I tried, practiced, and worked around it. In making a self-made video lesson, I started with outlining topics and contents from the curriculum. Then I write the scripts. After which, I set up my DIY studio at home. Yes, there is where the magic happens. I record videos, draw, and even conducted experiments in my table. For a variety of content, I contacted some of my friends locally and even in abroad to teach with me as if we are having a talk show. I sent them their scripts via messengers and they video themselves as if they were speaking with me. I will just crop the recorded videos and edit them using my mobile phones. There are many available video editors in online stores now, and all you have to do is to study and install them on your phone. Now, instead of perusing dense text on modules and books, students can engage with my lesson in an interactive way. Now, how can we ensure that students are watching actively? In my part, prior to streaming video, I let them enter a mission. For instance, I write on their module or in their guide, "As you watch, I want you to be careful about or make sure to answer this question after watching the video." Setting these objectives for what the students are watching will hold them accountable and attentive. It is quite difficult, most especially on the editing part, because it will really take time, but you have to be patient in making it. I receive feedback from the parents in our institution that the minimal data and bandwidth needed to view the lesson is effective in this distance phase of learning. It is indeed a powerful innovation, and it holds a promising future for blended learning. E-learning is becoming transformative in many ways, and as 21st century teachers, we have to adapt to the fast advancements in ICTs. Those who are resilient and adaptive will have to initiate and make solutions for us to move forward. It has been my mantra to light your own torch before you can light others. We have to isolate the unknowns and make ourselves confident. For this, we can handle even the worst case scenario. If we really have the will inside us, we can surely do it.
Welcome to your humble haven. This is Matter Day College of Tubigon, Philippines. Mater Dei College, as one of the leading institutions in Northern Bohol, Philippines, makes a significant impact towards development, innovation, and researches for the benefit of the community. Established in the year 1983, Mater Dei College is guided by its core values: wisdom through scholarship, charity through service, and prayer life through living the gospel. Despite the threats of COVID-19, changes in the educational system, and our quick shift to the new normal, we assure that the quality of our outputs are based on specific standards. This shall be done by formulating an approach that meets learning standards and transform the classroom for quality education. Because of this, Mater Dei College uses its main learning approach, the simplified online-offline learning approach. What is simplified online-offline learning approach? Simplified online-offline learning approach is an approach designed by the MBC Academic Council to cater different kinds of learners with the use of various methodologies. In this approach, one subject has 3 sessions per week, both online and offline. On the first session, all study guides and comprehensive learning materials created by subject teachers and approved by department heads are uploaded on the Learning Management System, or LMS. By this, students can download all of these materials and can read these study guides at home. To make sure that the students read these materials, teachers require the students to make a list of questions about the concepts from the study guides that are difficult for them to understand and comprehend. On the second session, the teacher shall meet the students virtually. The purpose of this online session is not for full discussion on concepts and topics, but to answer the questions created by the students during the first session. Moreover, the teacher will also raise questions to the students about the topic, and these questions are crafted based on the analysis to evaluative level of the revised Bloom's taxonomy. By this, the students and teachers would not take a long time in virtual discussion, and this saves resources both in school and at home. This is an advantage to our students because online sessions are in the form of a Q&A portion. On the third session, the teacher shall give an assessment to the students in order for the teachers to know if the students really understand the concepts. The assessment is created to know if the learning objectives set by the teachers on the specific lesson of the week are achieved. This shall be done in a form of online quiz, activities to be submitted via Gmail account, video making with the use of video making applications, and graphical presentation of concepts. The assessment varies based on what the learning objectives require. MDC implements this approach with the use of our own online-offline framework. Teachers follow the matrix, and all these methodologies within the 3 sessions are indicated on the teacher's instructional plan, which is regularly checked weeks prior to the session. The outcomes of this approach are visible to the teachers, parents, and students. To adapt to changes and the quick shift to the new educational scheme, because our approach is described in 3 C's: convenient, comprehensive, and creative.
I am George Itable, a full-time teacher, and I have been teaching here in Mater Dei College for 5 years. Simplified online-offline approach is reckoned to be effective, beneficial, and an edge in my own perspective. As curriculum designer, it allows me to apply both the pedagogical and andragogical methods in my teaching. Moreover, because of this approach, I become creative and sufficient with skills in the teaching-learning framework, establishing effectiveness of my instructional design. This approach helps me guide and monitor learners' progress, and thus enables them to adopt changes along with new trend in the academy.
I'm Judith Bagi, a parent of one of the students in Mater Dei College. For me, the learning modalities used of Mater Dei College are more convenient, besides great advantage to me as a full-time working mom. Furthermore, these learning modalities are perfect to all working parents in this time of pandemic.
I am Mariela Tibalagdas, a humanities and social sciences student of Mater Dei College. Studying in the actual learning environment for years, and then a worldly pandemic chaos just suddenly came up into our lives, limiting our access towards our academic pursuits, and we're being introduced to a new learning scheme, I just somehow felt and understood the sentiments and feelings to the students that have encountered this type of problem. However, I have managed to succeed and surpass all of those obstacles because of the aid and support of our new learning modality, which is the simplified online-offline learning approach that has been providing me ever since day one. The mode of the new modality, which is being applied to our academic institution, Mater Dei College, has truly helped me in giving quality works as well as to continue to move forward to the momentum of my academic excellence. Overall, the experience with the new learning modality journey has truly been great, and I am just so blessed, happy, as well as lucky to be able to have that kind of moment. Hopefully, in the near future, I could also be able to relive those particular moments and also be able to share it with others, with you.
In order for the school to deliver these mentioned services, MDC also invested in the internet connection, built virtual classrooms, and purchased a secure learning management system, or LMS. Students with Android phones can download the mobile application of the LMS from the Play Store. Because of the online-offline learning approach, it is possible for Mater Dei College to deliver quality education. Mater Dei College remains to be the cradle of eminence and the pride of Northern Bohol. As one big family, we are truly one in transformation. This is your Mater Dei College, where we make your dreams come true.
John, this is very interesting video.
Right, and I'm sure there's a lot of useful techniques that yes. schools can apply during
that's
this
right.
pandemic.
That's right. And thank you very much for the viewers in the YouTube channel.
How many viewers do we have right now?
I think we have about 800,
wow.
800 participants right now. And then the playback viewers is over 3,000 at the moment.
Thank you so much for joining us.
And we have the reflection here. How many? And I think that we have about over 200 reflections already within like, you know, 15 minutes. And John, would you like to share some reflections
sure.
to all participants?
So we have a reflection here from Lukman Raimi from University Brunei Darussalam. And he says, the session is insightful and very rich. The presentations are well presented and well delivered and well imbibed by the audience. And Kun Piepa, would you like to share one from Indonesia?
Yes, from the Hendra, SMK Negari Takawaru. And he mentioned that it's very interesting. Education in COVID era is different and usual for students, teachers. So we should study and make innovation for better education. Thank you very much for your reflection. And we would like to welcome more reflection from other countries as well, beyond Southeast Asia.
Right, yeah. So we would love to hear from everyone, wherever you are watching us today, please let us know where you're from and let us know how you're feeling about these videos and what your favorite video is so far.
Yes, even you submit the reflection already, you can come back the reflection form and submit again.
Right, if you've changed your mind and you like a different video.
Yes. So for the next chapter is about the innovation in teaching foreign language.
Right.
It's very interesting that we selected two videos. One from Indonesia and one from Malaysia. And they use different techniques, especially from Indonesia. They give the techniques how to teach Japanese language during pandemic and improve the Japanese language of the student.
Wow.
And for the Malaysia, they apply the appropriate application and tools to teach the student in the remote area. They're using the project-based education to teach language and arts.
Wow.
So, interesting one.
Yeah, let's take a look at the videos.
Thank you. Sensei. I'm teacher in Palembang City, South Sumatra, Indonesia. I teach Japanese at SMA Plus Negeri 17 Palembang, and I've been teaching for 12 years. We don't know when this pandemic will end. The implementation of remote learning actually has an opportunity that can be addressed with optimism in the world of education. The acceleration of education that occurred due to the pandemic by utilizing technology is a realization of the development of the digital era. In this case, pandemic is a catalyst for the better future. However, changes in learning methods that suddenly occurs are also a challenge for teachers as educational actors. Every teacher must have a unique story in dealing with this remote learning. At the beginning, there were no significant obstacles because of the experience during the previous semester. The remote learning had been implemented even though it was less than 3 months. However, it turns out that after almost a year of remote learning, obstacles began to appear. First, communication. Perhaps, same as other teachers, communication that can initially be changed directly in class to indirect or online class is certainly very different. And then, the stability of the internet network greatly determines to almost all teachers and students in our country. Communication is very important as well, considering the lesson I teach are foreign language lessons where it takes practice of listening, reading, writing, and speaking. So, this communication is very important. Second, motivation. Well, actually, motivation is the biggest problem that has to be solved. Students and educators' motivation sometimes needs to be upgraded. After doing remote learning for a long time, those of us will bore with such of routines. Moreover, for the students, every day they are faced with 3 or 4 different online lessons. You can imagine that every day for sure bored. Of course, as educators, we do not remain silent. Continue to motivate ourselves for the better generation. Luckily, during this pandemic, there are so many webinars, trainings, and online discussion for teachers. Discussion in teacher community are very helpful in getting new ideas for various ways of learning. And the most memorable thing at that time was the discussion with colleges from all over Indonesia and Japan, which was initiated by the Japan Foundation, which further boosted the confidence in teaching and education methods. Innovating and being creative by making a short learning video is a powerful idea. Even with light video editor software and devices, it has a great benefit for students. Design the simple learning management system for students. First, make the teaching materials as simple as possible. Don't think about fulfilling the curriculum. Design our e-learning with a short learning structure, clear instruction, and easy to understand. Design our 3 or 4 hours of lesson includes overview via virtual meeting or learning videos, materials, and exercises. Do it consistently. Minimize giving assignments which will make students overwhelmed and lazy to do. During the virtual meeting, provide motivation before learning. Collect testimonial videos from senior or alumni and share things about what the benefits of learning Japanese, the achievement, and make the impression that each meeting is unforgettable. Give prize to the student whatever has been done that day. give the challenges to students, because language learning is how to communicate, to talk, to write, and to read. Give feedback on each exercise or task given consistently and don't waste time. This is a very important thing, appreciating of the smallest effort by the student. Occasionally, give surprises related to Japanese language learning by presenting native speakers from Japan so students can practice the knowledge that has been obtained. Next, make a good engagement with students and parents. Prepare the extra time to respond to each student's questions about material that has not been understood via WhatsApp chat, phone call, or email. Through these treatments, a significant impact was seen from students. Enthusiasm in learning activities, a high percentage of attendance, disciplines, and complete assignment are evident. Keep on inspiring. Thank you.
Hello everyone, my name is Jasper Cyprian Maritus and I am a teacher. I am a degree holder in TESOL and underwent 5.5 years of teacher training program in Teacher Institute of Keningau campus. Currently, SK Salarom is the place I am teaching. Formerly positioned in the deep heart of the district of Nabawan, it was then relocated to a more reachable location. Surrounded by the greens, this school is next to a well-known village of Salarom for its nicely arranged houses. Little did we know, the state we are caught in somehow highlights the issues that we generally ignore or sweep under the rug. In my video today, I will share with you the methods that I used during the pandemic and how it is such a transforming experience for all of us. The traditional way of teaching and learning has been shifted to a home-based teaching and learning, or famously known as PDPR in Malaysia. We created a WhatsApp group for all classes, and from there, we distributed the homework or lessons of the week. For better understanding of the lesson, we moved to a module-based homework, as module-based homework is designed to guide the parents to teach and deliver the lessons to their children at the ease and comfort of their home. Module-based homework clearly states the objectives, the topic, theme, any notes related, content standard or learning standard, the activities, the assessment, and also a clear guidelines. One of many reasons why this method is widely used is because it increases the involvement of pupils in teaching and learning due to the fact that parents will be able to get the materials from the school or the designated station. This is also mainly because the issue is that not all families are equipped with proper devices, and not to mention the poor connection in certain areas of the villages that hinder them from getting any information and lessons that were delivered through WhatsApp. Since we distributed the modules weekly, we also get to collect the previously delivered modules and were able to grade or assess the pupils. Apart from that, we diversify our methods of teaching and use an interactive online quiz, which is quizzes.com. This is the most used method by me, mainly because it delivers a fun and interactive way of teaching and learning. It makes learning and answering quizzes so much fun for the students. Students can also see their scores and the leaderboard, which can motivate them to do better and be more competitive. Teachers have the ability to use features provided to make their lessons. Apart from being able to create your own lessons and quizzes,
It also allows you to explore and discover a wide array of quizzes from teachers around the world, a sharing platform not to be missed by educators. Ever since I use quizzes.com, I can see a 20% surge of engagement from my students for arts classes and 10% for English class compared to a more instruction-based lessons through just WhatsApp. Other than that, I can easily check the report of my students' performances and immediately give feedback. Another interesting way of delivering my teaching that I recently use is TikTok and also Canva. I believe everyone knows this app as it is so popular for its video sharing platform and Canva for a multiple template and easy to use presentation maker. The reason why I opt for this app is because students nowadays are familiar with this video sharing app and what is the best way of using it other than delivering lessons. I use it to record myself teaching about the respective topics and after that I transfer it to Canva. New vocabulary is also introduced in a fun manner. Parents can easily download the videos because of its low size as well. Another reason that I applied this technique is also because I'm aware of the different ways of learning by students, as some can learn better through visual and auditory. Hence, I want to cater to their learning needs, as through my videos, it can help and replicate the traditional classroom experience. Project-based learning is also another way or method that I use mostly for my arts classes. The wonder that I can see from using PBL for my arts class was that the students are able to utilize the nature and the things around them to execute the tasks given. It is very understandable regarding the limitation of materials and art supplies to be provided by schools to all the students during these trying times, so I encourage them to utilize everything that they can find at home. From recycled bottles, woods, and boxes to make trophies to teach them the concept of stability, leaves, food coloring to substitute watercolor, flour to make dough for pottery, and many other amazing things produced by the kids at home. Apart from having to learn the values of repurposing nature, it also shows how the pandemic does not hinder their creativity. I really hope through my sharing, it will inspire and help to tell our stories. Even we are faced with challenges, but that does not hinder us from trying and finding methods that will suit best to the situation and most importantly, our dear students. Thank you and goodbye.
So, John, as an English teacher before, how did you feel about the techniques?
Very useful. And I like how he used in the last video about using quizzes online, which really engage the students because they like to challenge themselves.
Yes, that's right. Yeah. That's right.
So, Kunpiepa, how many reflections do we have so far?
Well, we have like nearly 300 at the moment. And then I would like to highlight some reflection. John, would you like to highlight some?
Right. So we received one from Vietnam. His name is Nguyen Van Phu Thien. And he says, I think this session is meaningful and it is an interesting one for schools and educational organizations. And Kunpiepa, how about you? Do you have any reflections for us?
Yes, I highlight here. One from the Malaysia, Asim Saidon from the SNK Taman Pelangkian Indah. He said that it's really helpful in enlightening us with the solution pertaining the pandemic. And another one from Cambodia, Mr. Chang Ki Pin. Thank you very much for joining us. The session gives insightful idea for practical solution in this time of COVID pandemic. Thank you.
Yeah, that's definitely true. A lot of these videos can be applied or during this time of the pandemic.
Yes, that's right. And right. John, how about the next chapter?
So in the next chapter, we will be focusing on innovations in teaching science. And we have two videos in this chapter. One video is from Tinajero National High School in Pampanga, the Philippines. And the second video is from Semesta Secondary School in Semarang, Indonesia. So Let's take a look at these videos.
Yes, that's right.
Mabuhay! Greetings from the Philippines. I am Christian Ramos Basilio, a junior high school science teacher from Pinahero National High School Annex, a public school from Magalang, Pampanga, Philippines. In this video, allow me to share how I transform the different challenges brought by the COVID-19 pandemic into enabling opportunities using the power of educational technology. As a science teacher, it is always my goal to engage my students with meaningful and exciting activities in learning their science lessons. I always make sure that they are enjoying while they are learning. I believe that this is a pivotal way in enabling them to easily understand and appreciate their lessons and eventually apply it in their daily lives. However, all these practices were discontinued and limited when the coronavirus disease 2019 comes into place. A simple virus turns into a pandemic, which forces schools around the globe to cancel face-to-face classes. In the Philippines, the cancellation of face-to-face classes enabled the Department of Education to craft different learning delivery modalities to ensure that learning will continue even in times of crisis. This is the department's response to the call of the United Nations Educational, Scientific, and Cultural Organization that education cannot wait. If learning stops, we will lose human capital. Face-to-face classes are not the only important event in the field of education that was limited due to pandemic. Different in-site training for teachers was also restricted. But these limitations did not hinder me to continue igniting the torch for my passion for teaching and learning. I use these limitations as inspirations to move and think out of the box. In preparation for the implementation of the different learning delivery modalities prepared by the Department of Education, I engaged myself in different professional and self-improvement training in the form of webinars. I emptied my cup and let others fill me with new knowledge and innovations that I may apply in the new normal setting in the field of education. With these different webinars, I was able to acquire new skills, especially in the utilization of educational technology tools and often educational resources like website development, interactive ebook materials, augmented reality and virtual reality applications, Google applications, and the like. Indeed, once a teacher, forever a student. We do not stop seeking new learning. Our participation in different training programs is important in making our teaching methods relevant to the present condition of our educational system, especially right now wherein our educational landscape is constantly changing because of the COVID-19 pandemic. Our involvement in professional development training is just one of the manifestations that we want to be a catalyst of change. The different training programs that I attended did not only empower me as an individual, these programs also inspired me to empower and capacitate other teachers. I conducted various webinar sessions about the effective and efficient utilization of educational technology tools in the new normal setting of education. I also use these training opportunities to share my humble knowledge in making PowerPoint presentations that are high impact and engaging to the learners. These speaking opportunities did not only allow me to share and give what I have, but also help these teachers discover what they have within themselves to help themselves. The more than 50,000 teachers who attended these webinars are living proof that teachers are ready and willing to meet the demands of their profession, even in times of crisis. Aside from attending self-improvement training programs and empowering teachers through webinars,
I believe that one of my biggest success during the lockdown until now is the creation of my own YouTube channel, which now has more than 44,000 subscribers. This YouTube channel was conceived in my desire to support teachers in using educational technology tools and aid them in troubleshooting problems they encounter related to their teaching profession. Moreover, this YouTube channel is also my way of reaching my students who are in modular distance learning. Through my science tutorial videos, they can still feel that there is a teacher who is always ready to lend a helping hand and guide them on their science lessons. The positive feedback I receive from parents, teachers, and students who are the benefactors of this initiative inspires me to continuously create tutorial videos and continuously improve my craft. And you can also create your own YouTube channel. Together, let us reach our students. Indeed, the pandemic changed our educational landscape drastically. But let us not allow this endeavor to stop us from doing our best in empowering our students and colleagues. Let us continue in learning and improving ourselves. Remember, empowered teachers empower students. Let us maximize the power of technology in education in molding empowered 21st century learners. Let us continue in fulfilling our mission in delivering quality education to our dear learners, just like the times when there is no pandemic. Same mission, but different and more transformative and innovative ways of teaching and learning. Together, as we say in DepEd Philippines, Sulong Edukalidad para sa bata, para sa bayan. Again, this is Christian Ramos Basilio from Pampanga, Philippines. Dakal pong salamat, luwit kayo!
Hello, good morning, school leaders, educators, and students around the world. My name is Kuropa, a science teacher in Sumsta Secondary School, Indonesia. In this video, I will share an innovative online teaching learning during this COVID-19 pandemic. According to the survey that I shared to my students about their feeling of this online learning, I found that first, most of them felt bored to look at their screen and to sit in a period long of time. For your information, the students can spend about 5 hours a day to sit and to study in front of their screen. On the other hand, they want to do another activity that can make them to touch, connect, and learn directly from the environment. Secondly, biodiversity is one of the topics that is quite difficult if we teach only via online. To make this topic more interesting, it needs an environment, digital apps, and some curiosity. Third, students need a real activity to measure biodiversity, and they're still confused how to catch and how to observe small animals in order to study their classification. From the background that I explained before, I developed an innovative teaching learning method to this topic of biodiversity. And the innovative points are, number one, students can learn biodiversity in a real context. For example, they make quadrat to see what biodiversity level, and they build a trap to capture the small animals or insects. Second, students' digital literacy can improve by using the apps to identify species, to input the data, and to share the results with the friends. Let's check out this video to watch my students to relearn this biodiversity topic.
Hi, I'm Akmal, an 8th grader of Sumsta Secondary School. Learning biodiversity during the COVID-19 pandemic is quite boring if only reading books and playing simulator on computer. Fortunately, my teacher provided an exciting method to teach biodiversity topic.
Yeah.
My teacher asked the class to measure the biodiversity in the yard or garden nearby our home. Okay, let's follow me to see what I'm gonna do for this science test. Well, I'll measure the biodiversity, especially for the species richness. I can measure it with quadrat or measure within the area, but I'll choose to measure with area. So this is my biodiversity in my yard. I got 7 plants, but I don't know what's the name of the species. So I use this app called Google Lens. Okay, let's try. So the species is called Mangifera indica. Okay. And we got maybe the 2nd plant. Look, the name is Solanum nigrum. Next, I make a trap to capture the insect. First, I dig a hole. Then I put this glass into the hole. The next step, I mix this water with the soap to prevent the insect escape from the glass. Then I pour it into the glass. So I will check how many insects and animals will trap in the hole in the next 3 hours. Oh, I found this grasshopper being trapped into the glass. I actually know this is grasshopper, but I don't know what is the name of the species. So I use this app, it's called Picture Insect, to identify what is this species. Finally, I'll input the data with PowerPoint, and next week I'm gonna share it to my friend and teacher. That's all the activities I did. It's fun and makes me enjoy to study science during pandemic. See you and bye-bye!
From the innovative method that I teach in my class, the impacts for my students are, first, students are more enthusiastic to learn this biodiversity topic. Second, students' digital literacy are improved by using the apps when they identify species, when they input the data, and when they share with their friends in virtual meeting. As a conclusion, other teachers around the world can replicate this method to teach biodiversity topic, and I hope your students can be more excited to learn science during pandemic. That's all of my video. See you and thank you. Bye-bye.
Well, very interesting techniques to teaching science,
yes,
you know.
Because science is a hands-on subject, so
yes,
it's interesting to see how the schools have adapted to make sure that the students still are able to learn hands-on in some way.
Yes, and I hope that the teacher can apply the techniques even for science subject, but they can use for other subjects as well.
That's true, yeah.
Yes, and John, you know that amazing that now we have about over 300 reflections sending to us from different countries in Southeast Asia and even beyond, like India countries. And would you like to share the reflection from your
from
part?
Myanmar,
yes,
right? So we have a reflection from Nyo Nyo of the University of Mandalay in Myanmar, and he says the offline education system is quite effective if the internet related platform is well established. I think what Nyo Nyo is trying to say is that it should be a mixture of online and offline,
right? Yes, that's right.
And then we have another one, a reflection from Janet from the Department of Education in the Philippines. And she says, I'm really impressed about the presentations of the different countries, which are very informative and full of hopes and aspirations to combat the challenges of the pandemic for the educational sector. And Gunpiefa, how about you?
Well, I got two. One from Malaysia, from Shazril Samsudin, from the Ministry of Education, Educational Resources and Technology. He said that very interesting and highly valuable as it showcased the many creative, innovative and eye-opening activities for the educators. And one from India, Dr. Nagaraju from University of Madras, India. He's saying that, good, very nice presentation, excellent, keep up. Thank you very much for the reflection.
Yeah, thank you for sending in your reflections and keep them coming. We still have one more chapter to go.
Yes, that's right. And for this chapter, self-inspiration and improvement, right? It is very touching videos that produced by the students. And for your information, we received many good stories from the student, but we try to choose, select the one that share different views from the student. So we have like, we select two from the Malaysia and two for Philippines to showcase in this live session. But however, more videos that submitted by the students, like shortlisted and other interesting video, will be uploaded on the SEAMEO website. So you can view that.
Right. So all the videos, even though they're not showcased in today's limited time here on the pre-Congress lecture series, they can be viewed later on SEAMEO website.
Yes.
So let's take a look at the videos from this chapter.
Coronavirus disease attacked the whole world. Everyone was in chaos. The death reported day by day increased around the world. We were reminded to stay at home and protect ourselves during the outbreak. Studying online is the only solution during this pandemic, and that is how I started my day. Days and nights of going through learning, I hope my effort do not betray me. My hope is that my achievement would make my parents proud. I am a student, but I am also a child who bears big responsibility that I need to perform. This does not break my spirit to be more confident in achieving my dreams all the time. The journey of my study is not always beautiful. As a student, I often stress due to study. I do not understand what I learn. There were too many assignments need to be done. And also internet factors. The internet makes me lose mood to study. I thought everyone had this habit, eating, sleeping, or taking a nap, scrolling smartphone, and so on. Doing this boosts my energy sometimes. The point is I need to divide my time properly. I need to go through everything and slowly correct what is wrong. At one time, I prefer to study outside and find peace with the new environment. I like soothing scenery such as green trees, blue skies, and also mountains. It makes me relief. Study and study had become my daily routine during the pandemic. I cannot go anywhere freely and I need to quarantine myself at home, and all I could do is finding peace in my hometown. There are some tips on how I study during pandemic. Sometimes I miss spending time in college hanging out with friends. I miss my friends, I miss my lecturer, I miss the environment of college, I miss everything. Join many activities organized by the Polytechnic such as futsal, participate in Polytechnic sports day. And with my friends, we did almost everything together. And not forget, I explore reservoirs with my classmates. Go to the library for study groups, find reading materials, and spending time with besties. I really miss everything. I have achieved the target in learning that I want. This has given me enthusiasm for the effort I have done so far. I am happy with the journey of my life. I'm grateful for what I can do and for who I am today. I am always thankful for everyone who has been loving and helping me. And I will strive for my dreams no matter how hard it is until the end.
Pandemic has changed the lives of many. We face so many challenges, but for me, it has a very positive impact on our lives. It reminds us to go back to the very basic of life. As an educator, I experienced many struggles, especially for my students. They feel hard time to connect with our online classes. One thing that I appreciated most when they submitted their performances, but then still they exert much effort to perform those activities required on them. With all the struggles, with all the commitment, with all the effort, and I feel that they are very much willing to pass the subject. And so with this, I am very much happy that I have influenced them to have the positive thoughts facing this pandemic. And this reminds us that this pandemic, we have to go back to the basic of life. That is loving ourselves, our family, our mother nature, and above all, to be grateful with our Creator that this time of crisis, we survived and we will keep on surviving.
Community quarantine is hereby imposed.
Apat na buwan matapos ang dapat na simula ng school year 2020-2021, nakabalik eskwela na rin ang mahigit 24 alang sa mga kampung ng paaralan.
Upon knowing that there will be a lockdown, my mind went crazy and we were hysterical that time. My father lost his job and he don't have any financial support. He struggle every day in our daily needs, especially we are finding ways on how we can eat three times in a day. We don't have that financial stability because we are poor, and about my schooling, I was really hesitant if I should continue my schooling because we struggle every day. What if there's an online class and seeking for signal every day is really a challenge for me, and what if there will be an online class? I really don't know what to do. And I just really can't go on.
be preparing myself for whatsoever situation. A, alertness, being alert to whatever instruction and announcement from the school. B, discovering new ways and how to cope up physically in this trying time. A, allowing myself to rest if needed. Y, yes to time management. O, overcoming fear to face this new learning setup. And N, never stop the courage to face this new life. Self-development is a process of consciously improving oneself in various aspects of life. As for me, I've developed the sense of time management as well as the willingness to survive in this new normal setup. And I believe in myself that I can overcome these challenges brought by this pandemic. I believe in myself. I will because I can. And I did because I believe. Padayam.
The Iloilo Science and Technology University is committed to continue the education for the students as well as to continue the learning process despite of this pandemic. As a student leader, it is important to have different strategies in accordance to how we face a new normal setup. To conclude that in this new normal setup, we are not stagnant, but we are in the continuous process of learning, and that makes this organization very necessary and vital, because through communicating we are given the chance to speak, we are given the chance to raise awareness, to raise different concerns to the administration so that they themselves could also do something to help the students, because it is important that both parties, the students and the administration, is one way to continue and to adjust in this new learning setup. And that we may also remember that despite of anything, we have the courage, we have the right to perform, and we can do better to make things the best.
And this is our story. A notification changed our life forever. We were shortlisted amongst the top 10. Yep, that's us. We started out with a discussion. Turns out, the COVID-19 pandemic hit Malaysia like a storm. We felt hopeless and thought we had to give up. Another notification brought us back to our journey. The government allowed citizens to travel interstate, so we went back to work immediately. Continuous rain flooded our school, and we were due to meet our organizers on the following day. But luckily the school staff acted quickly and moved our trishots to higher ground. The meeting with the organizers went well. They were impressed and approved our trishaw. We were ready. We were certainly nervous. Who wouldn't be? We were school students going against universities and non-government organizations. Many people came to look at our exhibition, including the chairman of the Malaysian Innovation Foundation. After hours of anxious waiting, we were called to the auditorium for the prize-giving ceremony.
Pemenangnya disandang oleh Kumpulan E-Beca daripada Sekolah Menengah Kebangsaan Agama Syir Abdul Malik.
We even got featured in newspaper articles. This indeed was a truly memorable experience. And that's our story of success.
Fitness and health. Looking for a way to improve yourself and your fitness in this pandemic? Well, we got you covered. Let's do some home workout routines.
Working out? This is gonna be so hard.
Let's begin. All right, so for the first exercise, we are gonna do 5 push-ups.
5?
That's right, 5 push-ups. Now this might seem hard, but I'm sure you crewmates can do this.
Dear Lord.
All right, here we go. Let's start with the 5 push-ups. Right? Are you ready?
Here we go, guys. It's so hard. 5.
That was 5 push-ups. Our next exercise are gonna be 5 sit-ups.
5 sit-ups? As long as it's for my self-improvement, I can do this.
Alright, let's begin.
5 sit-ups. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Now that was 5 sit-ups. Moving on to our last exercise for this task, we are gonna do 5 jumping jacks. Don't worry, this is all for your fitness and for your self-improvement in this pandemic, guys.
All for my fitness and self-improvement. I can do this.
All right, 5 jumping jacks. Woo! And that was it for your first task, crewmates. Congratulations. You can now move on to your second task.
That certainly was hard. But I think if I want to improve and develop myself in this quarantine, I need to start focusing on my fitness and health and start working out. Thanks, Simon. I think I need to move on with my next task.
Is my task gonna be here? I need to check it out.
That's my task? It's gonna be so much to do. I can do it all in this time. What if the imposter gets me? I know I can do this. It's for my self-improvement. And for the betterment of the crew. I am a crewmate, and I know I can do this. I can do this!
Wow, who knew that doing this task really made me think about stuff, more about self-improving? Honestly, game devs, you were smart to put this task in the game. But I wonder how my crewmates are doing. I hope they're doing as well as I am, considering this was a task well done. Guess I just had to look for them.
I think I saw a task I need to do over here.
Call this. I guess I should call this number using this phone. I'm a little scared, but it's a task, so I'll do it. 0037. I guess that's it. Let's do it. Hey, it's me, Zai. Is this you, Jan? I've actually been focusing on doing my hobbies for a while now, since there's not much to do. It's been going well so far. Oh, you too? That's great. I gotta go though, Jan. I still have a bunch of other tasks to do. Okay, see you. Bye. It was nice talking to you.
Huh?
COVID-19.
So who do you think it is, guys?
I'm not sure who did it, but I was doing the call friend task earlier.
Well, it certainly wasn't me. I was doing the Simon Says task.
We all know it's COVID, right? COVID literally vented in front of me.
Yeah, I saw him do that too.
It must be COVID. COVID is the imposter, guys. Vote COVID off.
That said, I am voting for COVID.
Well, John, how do you think about the submission from the students?
Yeah, they were very, very good. Very well done. And I like the last video because we can apply it even if we're not students, such as keeping fit during this pandemic and being organized.
Yes, and the way that they present is quite different from individual students who submit to us, right?
Yeah.
But very inspiring.
And how many reflections do we have now?
Well, we have the reflection over 400 right now.
Wow.
Thank you very much. In the Google form that we create for you. And John, would you like to share with the participant forward reflections?
We have a reflection here from Gloria Bacani of Schools Division of Carino in the Philippines. And she says, I am happy to note how teachers upgrade themselves just to be an effective teacher in the new normal. So inspiring and worth emulating. And PFA, how about you? Do you have a reflection for us?
I have one from Thailand Assumption College, Thonburi. Ma Fe Esperano. So she's mentioned that the session very informative and helpful for the teacher during the pandemic. The different techniques and modalities can be applied for our class in different culture and language barriers. Thank you very much for these reflections.
Right. Thank you to everyone for sending in your reflections. And Kun Piepa, how about the ones with images? The reflections with images?
All right. Okay. We will compile together for the reflection that you submit to the webinar email address. webinar@seameo.org. You still have time to take your photo and submit reflection and photo to the email address, and also in our Facebook. #SEAMEO pre-congress. So we will compile everything together and put in the video clips.
Right, and share it on the SEAMEO website.
That's right, and including all the videos and the one that submitted today, present today, and all the shortlist and other interesting video will be on our SEAMEO website as well.
Great, so everyone can re-watch these videos and others that we're not able to showcase today.
Yes, that's right. And thank you very much for the teachers and students who submit the video clips for joining in this program, and also for the audience in YouTube, which we have about 800 participants joining live with us, and about 5,000 playback viewers at the same time.
Right. Thank you so much for joining us. And Kun Piepa, we have some announcements before we end the show.
Yes, that's right. And the announcement of today is about, again, SEAMEO Congress coming soon. And the deadline for the registration is 10 April, coming soon.
April, right. I mistakenly said in the first session that 10th April is next week, but actually 10th April is this Saturday, so
That's very soon.
Yeah, so all registration is free and it's online, so scan the code or visit the link on the screen.
And we would like to thank our main partner, Nissai Asia, Wiley, Chevron and Joysai, EEF, and Festo, who sponsor the free registration to our participants, and including the 15 supporting partners below the logo over there. They sponsor the speakers to join in our SEAMEO Congress. And let me show you the introductory of the video clips of the SEAMEO Congress. If you have not registered to the our SEAMEO Congress, that will be like very real virtual platform, very dynamic platform that you can learn and have new experience in joining us and with the over 100 speakers. And please register for the SEAMEO Congress by visiting our website, www.seameo.org. And this is the most asked question from our participants, John.
Yes, so the part that you probably all have been waiting for, how to get your e-certificate of participation for today's session. There is a link that you can access, or you can just scan the QR code on the screen and it will bring you to a form. Please ensure that your name that you spell and your email address is correct when you submit the form, because the system is automated.
Yes, so, that's right.
Yeah, so once you click send, it's the name that you've typed out and the email address is where we'll send it to. So if it's not correct, we can't fix it, unfortunately.
Yes, and you have only 12 hours to fill up the form, because it will close at midnight tonight. So please hurry up. And if you miss the link, you can go back to review the video clips in the YouTube live to capture the link for the certificate.
Or scan the QR code.
That's right.
And please allow for 1 month for your e-certificate to be sent by email.
That's right. In the last session, we had about nearly 5,000 participants asking for the certificate and fill up the form.
And this is why we need 1 month.
Yes, yeah. Our team is like, you know, handful trying to complete all the certificate for the participant on time.
Right.
Okay. I think that we are reaching to the end of the session.
But thank you so much for joining us. And we look forward to seeing you at the SEAMEO Congress on the 28th and 29th of this month.
Okay, and thank you very much for joining us and all the reflection. Now we have over 450 reflections sharing to us. You still can, like, you know, sharing your opinion and voices to us by using the form in the Google description.
Right,
sorry, like what have in you, the YouTube description.
Yeah. What have you learned? What was your favorite part? What was your favorite video?
Yes, that's right. Okay, thank you very much and see you again in the next SEAMEO learning session and in SEAMEO Congress.
Bye.
Bye-bye.
We'll achieve our goals through partnership, creating opportunities.